Hey, welcome back to Vikings Vantage, presented by Pepsi. Gabe Henderson here alongside Chris Corso and our guest of the night, Vikings defensive tackle Hercules Mata'afa. Hercules, thanks for joining, man.
Doing the skull chant. I love it.
I wish our radio audience could hear that and see that.
Eddie Murphy.
Oh, Hercules, Hercules, Hercules. I love it.
That's even better.
Oh, Hercules, 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 Hercules,
Hercules. Nutty Professor, right?
Yep.
Nice, nice. Well, I think now we can finally say you have completed your first career NFL sack. You get two straight weeks, two straight half sacks, and now it's one sack on the stat sheet, right? So right. Describe your sack this past Monday against the Bears, and where's your confidence level right now?
You know, I'm excited to play football whenever I get the chance to. And whenever I'm out there on the field, you know, it comes down to just playing ball. And, you know, that was what I was born and raised to do. So it's just me having fun out there at the end of the day.
Talk about having fun out there. You've been doing it from just about like every position for the Vikings so far. Coach Zimmer's moving you all over the field. You're in the middle of the defensive line. I saw you on Monday night. You're rushing from the edge. So tell Vikings fans kind of if you feel more comfortable doing that. Is that where Coach Zimmer likes you right now?
You know what? At the end of the day, I'm an undrafted free agent, and I'm comfortable playing anywhere. You know what I mean? I'm going to get it out. I'm going to get it how I can. And if that's playing three tag, if that's playing DN, nose is whatever for me. And I love playing D line, and you know, I don't think switching positions was really hard for me because I really know kind of everybody's role, and it was an easy transition for me to go anywhere on this D line and play.
I love that mentality, man. I feel like that mentality is like kind of trickling onto the team of just whenever they get the number called, go in and make plays. So for you, personal and team wise, what are some of the reasons for success as of late?
You know, our connection in the locker room, you know, we're excited to go out there and play. And, you know, we see ourselves winning. You know, the first couple games we're losing. You know, we didn't really know how to win yet. And once we start stacking these wins, our confidence is growing. You can see that in our locker room. And it's paying tribute out there to the field.
So when I talked to you earlier before the season on this exact show, we were talking about kind of – how you had these high expectations for the year and you really were looking for your opportunity. And that kind of isn't how the first part of the season went for you. You were actually sent back to the practice squad. So talk about that experience and what you did there to get back to the roster and have a huge game on Monday night.
Yeah, it goes back to reevaluating of who I am as a player. And, you know, I took that time as that short period of time I was on the practice squad, I took that as an advantage to work on my skills to get better so I can go out there and actually perform and show these coaches and the front office what I can do for them out on the field and how I can help this team win. And I think that my confidence is growing and, you know, I'm getting more and more comfortable out there.
That's interesting you say that because a lot of guys, you know, when you go back to the practice squad, it's one of those things where you just like, oh, man, like, maybe I'm not good enough, but for you, you actually went back to the drawing board. So, like, what were some areas of, you know, improvement that you put upon yourself to say, like, all right, I'll only be better at this?
You know, it is more comes down to like working harder, you know, really fine tuning your technique and really getting off the ball and just playing football and go back to what I love and find that love within football that I've had it since I was a little kid. And that was the secret recipe for me. And, you know, just going back and reevaluating how I found out to love football.
That recipe has certainly translated to the past three games. You have 10 quarterback pressures, only trailing DJ Wonnum on the Vikings defensive line in those past three games. So it's clearly something's working for you going back to the drawing board. So is it kind of just feeling like easier? And is the game really slowing down for you in these past few weeks?
Yeah, based off formations now, you know, I can kind of tell when I could take my shots and here and there and when I have to really play in and secure my gaps. You know, it's just coming easier and easier as I play more. And it's just me getting more comfortable while I'm out there.
That camaraderie, of course, I just brought up DJ Wonnum. It's a lot of young guys in this group. that camaraderie of, you know, coming in, a lot of these guys aren't highly drafted. I mean, what, no first-round picks on this entire D-line?
They can do that.
Yeah, like that camaraderie, like talk about that a little bit.
It's crazy, you know what I mean? We're all underdogs, you know? You look at DJ and then you look across the league, he's leading in pressures for all rookies, I believe, and he's like on the top of the list in every single stat for rookies, are, I believe, like top five or whatever it is. And, you know, across the board, we got Shamar. He was mm-hmm. seventh rounder, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Leo, fourth. Jalen, fourth. Afadi, seventh, you know. Mm-hmm. And this is their first time starting. So, you know, we all have that underdog mentality, you know. Everybody counted us out a couple weeks ago, and now we're showing up. And I think that – that's what's helping this team win is our D-line play and our overall defense and our whole team, I guess.
That room, there's a lot of different personalities in that room. Like you have Shamar and DJ who are kind of on the quieter side. Obviously, Daniil's not there. Afadi Odenebo is like, his personality cracks me up. Your personality is great too, but kind of talk about his personality and how he just brings that into the room and what he's done this year, because his role has really changed.
Well, Afadi kind of reminds me like the Mike Leach's personality in a way. You know, he's got he's kind of weird but goofy at the same time. It's like he's always funny, whatever he says. And I love Afadi to death, man. He's a great dude. He's a great dude to play with out there on the field.
Talk about Mike Leach, Washington State, right?
He's with Mississippi State now.
You're Mississippi State now, but you know. Moving back to the Vikings side of the ball, though, we talk about, you know, the personal progression. Week one, 10 snaps. Week three, 2 snaps. Week four, 6. The past 3 weeks, the past 3 wins, you've had at least 26 snaps. Your confidence level has to be, you know, building with that, with those snaps, but more importantly, with those wins. So mental preparation headed going forward, knowing that you're going to be counted on. How do you prepare to be depended on?
You know, just – being accountable to do my job and do what I'm asked to do out there, but also knowing when I could take my shot and when I can go out there and rush. And, you know, that's my strong suit is just rushing the quarterback, and I love to do it. That's my favorite thing in the world. And, you know, just learning how to pick and choose when I can go.
I saved my most important question for last, and this is a serious question that I need you to answer. You told me you were going to make me not Korean barbecue, but Hawaiian barbecue, which I am not familiar with at all the last time we spoke in August. So I'm still waiting. I mean, come on, man.
I got to call my mom and pops. They make it right.
Tell Vikings fans kind of what your parents make.
We can't give out secret recipes. You know, family tradition, they got all the secret recipes.
Just give me the entree. I want to hear what they are.
We got the Kelby steak, short ribs, the barbecue chicken, rice, you know, Spam mozzarella, all of that. And yes, I don't know what all that is, but.
I'm in for all of it.
In a non-pandemic year, I'm going over to your house for family dinners.
Yeah, come on through.
Well, we appreciate your time today, man. Hercules, thank you again. Best of luck this upcoming Sunday. Dallas Cowboys primetime purple. I know you're excited, man.
Let's go. Those jerseys are going to be sweet.